Welcome to another How It Works with Holger. Being developers, we have to learn new things every day. And to be honest, it has become impossible to remember everything. And we need documentation. I have to look up so much stuff in documentation that I literally have all my favorite bookmarks for the different frameworks that I use, for example, for the different programming languages that I use. For example, the Delphi doc wiki is a bookmark, the Bootstrap site is a bookmark, the Tailwind site is a bookmark, and I have to look up things constantly. And during my summer travels, I came into the situation that all these documentation pieces are online. And if you're traveling, you might not have the best internet connection or even no internet connection at all. Only a few airplanes that for international travel do have an internet connection. So what to do? And that's what we look at in this episode. I'll show you a way how you can more or less create offline documentation for web development. And of course, for Delphi and TMS Web Core, Delphi has the documentation and help file still, and TMS Web Core has a great PDF document. And of course, my books are on paper, so you won't have any issues downloading those. However, the web frameworks in particular for web development are always online. And this tutorial will show you how you can use them offline. The best thing, you can do this all for free. All the tools that I will show are available freely on the internet. To get you started, we will look at three famous frameworks. Number one is Bootstrap, number two is Tailwind, and then the Mozilla web documentation that has everything about HTML and CSS you could ever desire flying on a plane from the United States to Europe that you might have to look up and forgot and don't have books for. So these three are perfect, for example, for web development, if you want to do some development while in the air. In order to get started, create a folder on your hard disk. I created a folder named Live, and this folder is open on my console. You can do the same thing with PowerShell or Windows command line. Same thing. All the tools that I'm showing are platform independent. That means you can run them on Windows, Mac, and even Linux is not going to be a problem at all. In order to make sure that you have all the tools that we need installed, type node-v, and that should give you the version number of node that is being installed on your system. At this point, that should say version 20.17, that's the long-term support version. If you don't have this version installed, go to nodejs.org, right here, that's the webpage for Node.js, go to download, and I can wholeheartedly recommend using the NVM installation because that allows you to install multiple versions of Node at the same time. And here's the commands that you need to type in order to install it that way. If you're not big on command line, there's also pre-built binaries. So there is no need to use the command line. There's installers that you can use in order to install it, both for Windows, macOS, Linux, as I said, and also for the different platforms like ARM and Win64. This will get you started with most documentations that I'm going to show. I'm going to show one more approach. That's why I have the MDN, the Mozilla one in here, because that uses a different package manager. Because Node comes with the NPM package manager, NPM -v gives you the version number of that one. There's also another one called Yarn. And Yarn is now part of Node by default. The only thing you have to do, you have to enable it. So if Yarn-v doesn't work, you have to enable Yarn. So installing Yarn has become pretty simple. If you're here, you see that this documentation covers Yarn 1 Classic. You want to click here, yarnpackage.com. And then if we go to installation, we see that we only need to run core pack enable. Obviously, that requires you to have NPM installed. So if you do yarn, basically, if the yarn-v fails, you have to say core pack enable and you're good to go. And then yarn.v will work for sure. As said, most of them just work when you install Node. There is no need for Yarn, but some offline documentations require you to use Yarn. You'll see it right away how it works after doing one, two of them, and it will be very, very easy. You will never have to install this again, really. This is just the requisites that you need in order to do this. Let's start with Bootstrap. The page get Bootstrap gives you the documentation for Bootstrap. So if you go to docs here, this is the whole documentation. You have it in the browser and you might think, oh, well, I basically get this web page, download the web page. Don't even try. It's not going to work because there's like JavaScript stuff here. Converting it to PDF, I've seen that too. That's also not a good solution. The best solution really is that I'll show you right now. And what you need to do is you need to go to GitHub, and GitHub actually hosts all the different source codes for these projects, and that includes the documentation. That's the cool stuff. So if we go to Bootstrap here, see Bootstrap, boot, you go to the repository TWBS/bootstrap right here, GitHub TWBS bootstrap. And if you scroll down, there's already a hint that it is possible to download the offline documentation right here, that it's included. The documentation is included. And in order to run it locally, you have to use these commands. And that's what we're going to do. At first, of course, we need to copy all these files onto our computer system. So we click on code and copy this URL here into the clipboard. And then we can type git clone. And I'm not even going to ask if you have Git installed. If you're a Delphi developer, that is basically a given that Git should be installed on your system in the year 2024. If it is not, well, remedy that right away. Download Git. And you can get it for Windows, for Mac, and everything else right here. You can download the binaries and just run it from your console afterwards. So git clone, paste, and then basically this would install it in the live directory. I don't want that because I want to pick the directory myself. I'm going to say create directory, and I'm going to say Bootstrap. Obviously, I could also use the Windows Explorer if I wanted to, or the Mac Finder, so you don't have to use the command line for all of this. And in this Bootstrap directory, I'm going to say git clone, paste, space, period. That's the important thing. Okay, don't forget the period, space, period. That means clone it into the current directory. Otherwise, what would happen is, if you do it without specifying the period, it would create a directory called bootstrap.git, and that's ugly. So just use this one. And it says cloning into period, and that takes, depending on your internet connection, a little bit. And here we go. And if we now look at the directory, all the files are there. Just for completion, you can type code period if you have Visual Studio Code installed. And then you can actually look at all the different things that are included in this repository and look also where the files are, the different parts of a framework. It's really, really interesting to browse it this way. But we don't need Visual Studio Code to continue. Instead, we go back to the web page and look at the documentation steps that are required. And then we just have to run npm install, npm run test, and at that point, we can say npm run docs serve. And this is the command you have to repeat every time. So 1, 2, you only run once. And whenever you want to look anything up in the documentation, you run this. You can create a batch file for this. So I say npm install. And this will now install all the packages that Bootstrap needs. That will actually take a little bit longer. Well, work quickly. And then I can say npm run test, right? As it said in the documentation, and this will test, run all the necessary tests and create all files that I needed to run a local web server for the Bootstrap documentation. That's the cool thing. So in a nutshell, what we'll be doing is we will run a web server that hosts the documentation as if you were hosting the web page with the documentation on a server. That's what we'll be doing. So you can browse the documentation locally on your own computer system without having an internet connection. So this is literally the best way to have documentation offline, in my opinion. Okay, now the last files are being downloaded and created. And at some point we should get a message that the tests have been successful right here. There's no error message. And then the last part from the documentation is to say npm run docs serve. So I say npm run docs serve. And this is what I have to repeat each time, because what happens is, if you look here, it says web server is available at localhost port 9001. So if you now go to your web browser and go to localhost port 9001, press enter, and there is Bootstrap, believe it or not. So this is the server that is running based on the files that are on your hard disk. So if you now go to docs, don't go to any of these other pages, because these are not available right now. But some of them, for example, the icons page does have a separate repository that can also be installed offline. So if you wanted to look up the icons for Bootstrap while you don't have an internet connection, perfect, use that. And of course, it's not only suitable or cool to have these things if you don't have an internet connection. It is also something that allows you to exit it inside of a network where you might not want to access the internet. So this is really cool. You click on docs and here is the complete documentation. Also different modes, light, dark, and different versions. However, if you go here, that is not available. It's always the last version, because if you click another one, it's linked to the internet page again. So only the current version, or the version that you checked out with Git. So we cloned the most recent one. So if you wanted to have any of these other versions, you would have to clone the Git repository for that version, and then you could host that version as well. So here we have the containers, everything is there. It's absolutely amazing, and it's all on localhost. And the same thing we can do for Tailwind. So I go to the Tailwind repository, and I have to cheat because I can't ever remember what the repository names are. So I add stars to them, and here we have Tailwind CSS right here. And then I scroll down. And this is same thing, even easier, npm install, npm run dev. And again, we need to clone this. So we copy this URL. And on the console, we stop the web server for Bootstrap. We say mk directory, and this is Tailwind, cd tailwind. And then we say git clone paste, don't forget the period. And we clone that repository. So we now create a copy of those files on our disk. And when that is completed, we just run npm install and npm run. The reason why that is possible, this is just a tidbit, the web page itself is a Next.js project, or the documentation itself is a Next.js web project. So you're literally becoming a Next.js developer when you look at the documentation for the project. So we install all the package dependencies, and npm is something that the web community is replacing right now because it takes a little bit. Then the next command, we look it up in the documentation, npm run dev. So we say npm run dev. And this starts the compilation of the Next.js application, but it already says like your server started on localhost port 3000. So we can go to our browser, say localhost 3000. And you can also see in the background that it's still being compiled on demand. And here is the Tailwind website, the documentation offline. So we go to docs, and you have the whole documentation for Tailwind offline. And that is really, really helpful, because who can remember all the different spacings or all the different column breakpoints that are available, or the different colors? Everything is included. And the nice thing is, it is stored on your computer now. You don't need an internet connection if you want to access that. Now to the more complicated one, MDN. Let me just show it to you what it looks like online. This is a resource for developers, by developers, and you can literally look up anything, like Flex, for example, for the for CSS, how flexboxes work, the different any tag, everything is documented. And to have that with you offline is just very, very good. One thing I forgot to mention, of course, if you have the documentation this way, the search and these things all work. So if you, for example, want to search for something here in particular and you type flex and flex wrap, this works because it's the website itself. So the search functionality, everything works. It's really, really nice. And if you want to go to these GitHub repositories quickly, just go to, for example, tailwindcss.com is the webpage online. And this is how I found the GitHub repository here on the right upper corner. I clicked on GitHub and this is how I got the link initially. Okay, so let's do the same for the MDN. Let's see if they have something like that. See, they hide it a little bit better. So not everybody is so open about the fact, but here, if you look here, GitHub MDN, they have this here, web docs, and then they have different projects available. And the one that I will look at is the content one. So we go to content, code, we copy this one. We go back to the console, we control C, CD, and then MK directory, MDN, CD, MDN, then git clone, paste, period, in order to clone that. And then we have the complete MDN documentation on our hard drive and can run it as a local web server again. However, they added a little bit of a novelty in there. It's not just NPM. They use a different package manager. They use Yarn that we looked at initially. So in order to run this, we need to say Yarn and then Yarn start Yarn. So now everything gets downloaded, the dependencies, perfect. And then we do Yarn start and that starts the web server on port 5082. This, not this one here, this one 5042. So we go to localhost 5042. And there you go. There's your references for all the different stuff. Here's the reference for HTML, all the tags. There's the reference for CSS. It's amazing because if you are without internet and can't access certain things and you just don't know what the parameter was, this is such a useful thing to have. It's unbelievable how easy it is to do. And of course, if you want to update this, you just say git pull, and then you get the most recent documentation, right? You can do this for all of them. So you basically go to, for example, let's say Bootstrap, CD Bootstrap, then you say git pull, and then it will update to the most recent version. And then, of course, you have to run the whole rigmarole again, but you can create batch files in order to do that and a separate batch file to start this server. Another nice thing is they all start on different ports. And if you know a little bit more or look up into the configuration files of these things, for example, you most likely will run into situations where two developer documentations use the same port and you want to use them at the same time. There are means, of course, to change the ports of these things so that you can run them at the same time. All in all, it's great that these are available offline. So the rumor that modern documentation is no longer available offline is not true. You can still look at everything offline. The only thing is you have to run a local web server and that will make it possible to browse documentation offline. Thank you for your interest in this episode. I hope you found this useful. Click subscribe to get updates on upcoming videos in the future. And also remember to give us a thumbs up. Thanks so much. Take care. See you soon.